If you have an Apple device and you want to cast your audio using AirPlay to Google Nest speakers, you can use a Raspberry Pi to bridge the two together, and it's fairly simple to get started. In this video, I'm going to show you how you can use a Raspberry Pi as a bridge between your Apple devices and your Google devices, so you can enjoy your music and audio even if you're not fully within Apple's walled garden. To get started, I've just opened up PowerShell on my computer so I can SSH into the Raspberry Pi. So let's just do that now. Right, so we're logged in to the terminal of the Raspberry Pi. Now the first thing that we're going to want to do is do this in the varlib directory, just so we can set this up as a service later on, so we can set this to automatically run when the Raspberry Pi boots up. So let's go to that directory now with cd /var/lib. Now we're in that directory. Now let's make a new directory called AirConnect, where we can download all of the files that we need to get AirConnect up and running. So we're going to do sudo, which acts as a command to do things as the super user. Then we're just going to make a new directory called AirConnect. So now let's go into that directory that we've just made. So cd AirConnect. And now what we want to do is just double check what version of Raspbian we're using on the Raspberry Pi. As now that the Raspberry Pi is 32 and 64-bit, you want to make sure that you download the correct version for your Pi. So what you want to do is use the following command, which is uname-a, and this will tell you what version you need to download from AirConnect on GitHub. So for this, I'm on a 64-bit build of Raspbian, so I need to download the Arch 64 version, but if you're on a 32-bit version, then you'll want to download the standard Linux-ARM version. So now let's download the file from GitHub using wget. So we're going to do sudo wget, and I'm just going to paste in this command because it's quite a long link to put in. So we're going to do that, and I just right-clicked there in PowerShell to paste that, and then I want to do aircast-linux-arch64. If you're on a 32-bit version of Raspbian, then you'll want to use aircast-linux-arm. So now we're just going to download that from GitHub, and as you can see, it has downloaded to the folder. So now what we want to do is make it so we can actually run this file, because at the moment, we're not allowed to run this file. So what we're going to do is use a command called chmod. I'm going to do sudo chmod plus x, and then the name of the file, -arch64. Obviously, adjust the command based on the file that you downloaded for your Raspbian version. Now we've done that, we can run this file, and what we're going to do to run that is just do a full stop and a forward slash, and then the name of the file. And there we go, as we can see, the AirCast version is now running on the Raspberry Pi, and you can see it's found a couple of Nest displays in the home that it's added. So let's press Control C to stop running that, and we can see that it's now stopped and we're back at a normal prompt. And let's do a couple of things. So we want to make sure that it's made a configuration file, and if it hasn't, then we want to make one. So let's just do ls-a, and this will list all the files in the folder. And as you can see, it doesn't actually have a command file. We have a couple of full stops to show various directories that are above this one, as well as the AirCast Linux file itself. So let's do a couple of variables to actually make that command file. So this time, as we're making some extra files on top of what we're doing, we're going to use the sudo command again, and then we're going to do full stop forward slash, and then your AirCast file, which in my case is AirCast Linux Arch 64. I'm going to do -i, and then I'm going to do aircast.xml as my configuration file name. Now that we do that, that's just going to go in, scan the network, fill in that configuration file, and then once it's done it, it'll close that file back down. And there we go. So it took a little moment to go through, but as you can see, it's automatically finished that process, and now we have a configuration file in our folder as well, which is aircast.xml. Now, if you are going to run AirCast in the future as a non-service, you'll want to make sure to pick up that configuration file when you start AirCast in the future. So you just do your commands of aircast-linux-arch64-x to imply a custom configuration file, and then you do aircast.xml. and that will start AirCast using that XML file. So I'm just going to press Control C to close that, and let's carry on with the tutorial. So now we actually want to get this running as a system service. So when the Pi boots up, it just automatically starts AirCast, and we can just cast from iOS devices and Macs using AirPlay to a Nest speaker. So let's do that. What we're going to do is make a service file in the system folders. So we need to move to a new directory. So we're going to do cd /etc/systemd/system. And now that we're in this file, we want to make a new file called aircast.service. So what I'm going to do is do sudo nano, which is the text editor, and I'm going to do aircast.service. And this will bring up the text editor where we can now copy in our code. And I have written this ahead of time because it's quite a lot to put in one go. So we need to fill in a couple of bits here. So what we want to do is just confirm the file name that we have. So this is the file name that you downloaded from GitHub. So this will either be your 32 or 64-bit version. So it's, in my case, it's the 64-bit, which is in there. And so what we're going to do is we're going to do Control X to save it, and we're going to press Y to save it. And there we go, we're going to press Enter. And that is that file done. So now if we look at the files, we can see aircast.service is in there. So now let's enable this service so we can actually make use of it. So we're going to do sudo systemctl enable aircast.service. And there we go, that's made a link. And if you ever want to disable it, you would just do the same, but change enable to disable, and that will let you disable the service in the future. So now let's get started and run this service. So we're doing sudo service aircast, and then we're just gonna say start. And there we go. That will start the aircast service, and we're all good to go, as we know, because it's taken us back to the command line. So now if I look on my phone, I should be able to see the additional services on my phone, and I can. So that means that the service is all good to go, and it's running. And if you ever want to check if the service has run, then you can do sudo service aircast status, and that'll tell you if it's active and running, and it'll tell you how long it's been running for. So this is quite useful if your Raspberry Pi does reboot. And there we go, we can just press Control C to get out of that. But that is how you get AirPlay on your Nest speakers when you have Macs and iOS devices all working together, so you can cast your media wherever you want it. Thanks for watching this tutorial. Please give it a like and subscribe if you found it helpful. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.